Today I'll be showing you one of my own strategies that has performed well since I started trading it 5 years ago. However, I'll be running a simulation to show you what would have happened if I traded it with different levels of leverage than I actually did. I'm sure that this will be an eye-opener to many people in terms of just how dangerous over-leveraging really is. Darwinex is a UK FCA-regulated broker and asset manager on a mission to disrupt the financial trading, investing, and asset management industries. As a trader, you'll benefit from cost-effective market access via multiple trading platforms and APIs. These enable trading and investing in any US stock, over 60 of the most liquid futures contracts, FX and CFDs. You can even diversify your portfolio by buying and selling other traders' strategies as investable assets themselves. So, if all of that sounds interesting, learn more by clicking on the link top right now or find further links in the description right below. Now back to today's tutorial. Can a strategy that's performed really well over a 5-year period using a sensible leverage really be impacted that severely by over-leveraging? Well, let's see. What we have here below the chart are all of the trades that were taken in one of my Darwin's TRO over the last 5.5 years. And remember that this is a simulation, so what I'm able to do is make the position sizing or the leveraging either more aggressive or less aggressive. And in the model, I can also adjust whatever the starting equity is that I want to simulate. So I've got that set to £5,000 at the moment. So the blue line here is obviously the equity curve. The orange is the high watermark. And the grey is what I've defined as my risk tolerance. And this at the moment is set to 15%. So what that means is that if the equity line falls and touches that line, at that moment in time, I'm at a 15% drawdown. And obviously, as the equity increases, the distance between the high watermark and the risk tolerance also increases in proportion. So here, this represents maybe a 12% drawdown. Now, the actual figures can be determined on the left-hand side here. So the largest drawdown is actually 13.91, which will be represented by this one here, and then you can see that in the drawdown chart underneath also. And you can see that whenever equity is making new highs, we can see the drawdown level down here is zero. Now, the compound annual growth rate using this aggressiveness is 33.8%. And what I'm going to do first is to make the position sizing less aggressive, therefore reducing the leverage that I'm using throughout the time period. And as we do that, you'll notice that the drawdowns decrease. So now this worst case drawdown that we had before that was just over 13% is now just a little over 7%, 7.17. So as we halved the position sizing multiplier, we halved the drawdown, and the compound annual growth rate also halved, just a little bit more, and that's because of compounding. And if we reduce this again, we'll see these values approximately halve again. So let's now take this the other way, and let's start to increase the leverage beyond the baseline that we started with, and we'll double the aggressiveness again. Now what you can see is that the blue equity curve is actually breaching the 15% risk tolerance, and the maximum drawdown now is 26%. But look at the compound annual growth rate. Although the drawdown has pretty much doubled, the return has more than doubled. So this has gone from 33% to 75%. And again, the reason that's more than doubled is because of compounding and exponential growth, which of course is what we're all after. So let's continue. As we double the aggressiveness again, we get even more compounding. But to get this level, you'd need to be able to tolerate a 46% drawdown. Now, in my experience, most traders wouldn't be able to do this, and many of them would actually stop trading at this point. So let's increase again. And we're now up to a 73% drawdown, and you can probably guess if I double this again, we're going to bankrupt the account, which happens here. So we're left with just 2% of our high watermark level. And just to take this to its extreme, we now completely bankrupt the account here. So it's one of those earlier drawdowns, which under normal leverage looked fairly small and insignificant. But now it's one of those that has now bankrupted the account under this much higher leverage. So I'm going to return to my original question, where I asked, can a perfectly good system that looks like this still destroy your account under high leverage? And the answer is yes. And it's the same answer for any trading strategy that suffers drawdowns as part of its equity curve. And that therefore means every strategy, because there are no strategies that don't suffer drawdowns. So in the last two episodes, I've now covered this concept of overleveraging, coming at it from two completely different angles. One looking at an actual strategy on the Darwinex platform, and one looking at a simulation of one of those strategies under different leverage conditions. And I'm hoping that either one or both of those have increased your understanding of overleveraging and the dangers that it poses. Now, you'll be glad to know that in the next episode, I'll be covering a rather lighter subject, and one that's much more positive in nature. We're going to be looking at the performance fees dashboard and the intelligence that this can provide us with as strategy providers on the Darwinex platform. So if that's already available, you'll see it top right now. But until then, trade safe.